actress Roseanne Barr arrives at the Golden Globe Awards on Jan. 7. Roseanne Barr apologized Monday for calling billionaire George Soros a Nazi in late May. His family was persecuted by the Nazis. His family was persecuted by the Nazis. Learn more of the truth about this at https://t.co/8gj3xzpznc, Roseanne Barr, at the RAL Roseanne, June 11, 2018. Barr recycled a popular right-wing conspiracy theory about Soros, namely that the 87-year-old Jewish Holocaust survivor was actually a Nazi sympathizer who helped send his coreligionists into the gas chambers. Last month, in a series of offensive tweets, Barr also attacked former first daughter Chelsea Clinton and former Obama White House advisor Valerie Jarrett. Her racist comment about Jarrett ultimately led to ABC canceling Barr's sitcom, Roseanne, and the actress apologized to Jarrett hours later. "Good morning, Roseanne. My given middle name is Victoria. I imagine George Soros's nephews are lovely people. I'm just not married to one. I am grateful for the important work that Open Society does in the world. Have a great day." https://t.co/mxokitune7, Chelsea Clinton, at Chelsea Clinton, May 29, 2018. "Sorry to have tweeted incorrect info about you. I please forgive me. By the way, George Soros is a Nazi who turned in his fellow Jews to be murdered in German concentration camps. Soros was 14 years old in 1945 and hid his Jewish identity to escape Nazi persecution in Hungary. In his biography written by Michael T. Kaufman, Soros describes assuming a Christian name to hide in plain sight during the German occupation of Hungary. He also recalls once accompanying a Christian government official to take an inventory at the mansion of a Jew who had fled the country. When asked about the experience during a 1998 interview with 60 Minutes, Soros said he didn't feel particularly guilty about the incident because he was there as a spectator. "You went and helped in the confiscation of property from the Jews?" asked host Steve Croft. "Was it difficult?" "Not at all," Soros responded. "Maybe as a child you don't see the connection." Kaufman, however, noted in Soros' biography that the financier spent years in therapy, dealing with the impact that his temporary, necessary, and pragmatic denial of Jewishness at the age of 14 had on the development of his personality. Related coverage: Michelle Wolf, "Roseanne shouldn't have been revived to begin with." Trump responds to ABC's Roseanne cancellation by making it all about himself. Roseanne returns to Twitter to push more racism download.